What's up, guys? It's your boy D-Dog here. This is a Tuesday video. Not your typical video that I'm bringing out today, but I have every reason why I'm bringing out this video this early. So, as you notice, I have not been posting any type of shoe releases at all. I have not been, all the releases I have not been buying, and that's for good reason. I haven't bought any shoe releases, so it's been, and it's for a good reason. Basically, I got too many damn shoes, all right? And I'm just going to be honest. Shoes, it ain't all about shoes, okay? And I just want to give y'all a brief thing of what's going on. So, pretty much, man, I bought another car. Let's talk about the car that I got. The car that I bought was, it's so funny. So, I don't think I ever posted my car on Facebook, on YouTube back in the day, about a couple years ago, but that's my motorcycle right there. I don't think I ever posted my car on YouTube. So a couple years, I want to say about a good 4 or 5 years ago, I used to own a 2005 Dodge Magnum. I had a 2005 Dodge Magnum. Pretty much, I'm gonna be honest, man, I dogged that car, man. It was my first time having a Hemi. And literally, I was just driving it everywhere. I drove it to Indiana, I drove it to Chicago to go to fighting game tournaments. I did everything. Pretty much, like, after a while, I didn't take care of the car. Pretty much, the valve dropped on it, and pretty much, it was done. But later on, I found out that it was a $500 fix, but me being me, I was like, fuck it, just get another car. But I didn't get another car. I ended up I had a truck and then transmission went out on that because I was using that for a delivery job and I didn't have a car. So all I had was my motorcycle and I was frequently using my wife's shit, just to get to work and then come home. I'm gonna show you guys the car in a minute, but I'm just gonna tell you guys a story. So what happened was I literally Sunday morning, came across a Facebook post. The Facebook post, the guy was selling a 96 Impala SS. I really wanted it. And I knew the price, he had all the parts that needed to be put on. He just didn't want to put it on the car. I wanted the car so bad, but I knew the price that he had it for, it wasn't going to sit and stay at that price. I got paid that following Friday. I could have asked, my dad to front me the rest of the cash to get the car. And then I would have had a 96 Impala out there because that's one of my favorite cars. 96 Impala, Dodge Magnum, or 1964 Impala SS. Those are like my three favorite cars. Three favorite muscle cars, I'll just say that. However, I talked to the guy and he was just like, I'm just trying to get rid of my cars, landlord tripping because I got all these cars in my lot. And I was just like, oh, okay, cool. All right, well, what all you got? And this guy was just like, he was like, he had some other shit that I didn't give a fuck about. And then he said a Dodge Magnum. Mind you, I used to own a Dodge Magnum. So I'm like, well, what year is the Dodge Magnum? And he was like, well, the Dodge Magnum is a 2007. I used to own a 2005. So I'm like, okay, is it a Hemi? Does it have a Hemi in it? And he's like, yeah, it has a Hemi in it. And he was like, it got some rust on it. And I'm like, okay, rust can get fixed. You know what I'm saying? I'm sitting there, I'm like, okay, rust can get fixed. He was just like, well, it needs this, this, and that. He put a new transmission in it, and he was like, all right, bet. He's like, the car just won't go out of first gear. Me knowing how the Dodge cars are, it can be a simple fix, man. So I said, all right, I'll come look at it. I go look at it, he sent me a video. I stayed in contact with him. He sent me a video and literally I was like, yo, can I come look at it? And he was like, all right, bet. He gave me a price. Said, if you come look at it today, I'll give it to you for $1,500. I was like, this too good to be true, dog. You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, okay. So I go look at it. I take my cousin. I'm going to show y'all pictures of my old Magnum. And then you can see, when you see this one, you'll be like, oh, okay. I go see it. I look at it, I was like, yo, okay, start it up. Man, the car wouldn't start up. Car has been sitting, so they had to try to get the car jumped or whatever. What happened was, because the battery was so dead, it just would not crank. So I'm thinking like, man, maybe this shit locked up. I ain't buying this bitch, it ain't locked up. So they tried to put it on the jumper. They tried to get it to start and it just would not start. So he literally told me like, bro, I'm telling you the car will start. So he said, I put it on my mama. I put it on everything, bro. And I'm like, man, all right, man. I just want to, if it start, bro, I'm buying it. You know what I'm saying? Because I know how to fix these cars, damn near. Because I had one. Pretty much, he was like, man, just give me $1,200. He said, just give me $1,200 today, bro. You can have this bitch. That's how Detroit people talk, man. When they just, like, man, come on, man. Just give me $1,200. You can have this bitch, cuz. And I'm sitting there like, all right, I'll be right back. I went to the ATM machine. I had the money in my pocket just in case this bitch started. Bro, do you know I came back? The fucking car still wouldn't start. I told my cousin, I said, hey, cuz, go over there, pull your Tahoe up and charge this bitch up. Man, he pulled this shit up on them fucking, he jumped that motherfucker, that car started right up, bro. So, I got this car for $1,200. He told me that it would not go out of first gear, right? I immediately got the car towed to a Dodge dealership, you know, in Michigan. I had it in my head that this was gonna be a $600 fix or a $900 fix. Cause he told me, oh, the PCM is messed up. The PCM is messed up. This issue on this car, that all it needed was two things. The one thing I shouldn't even have gotten, but I got it anyway, just for a peace of mind. And that was a PCM flash to update it to the newest shit, PCM and TCM upgrade, and I of course replaced the battery. Do you know the mechanics told me that all this car needed was a new battery? Because of the low voltage in the battery, the car literally only, that's why it was not allowing the car to shift in other gears. It was only stuck in first gear. So I bought a car for I bought a Dodge Magnum for $1,200, and I only put so far $400 to $500 into this car, because I wanted an oil change, because I didn't know what, you know what I'm saying? You don't know how, when you buy cars, you gotta do your due diligence and change all the shit out that the previous owner had. So I'm gonna show you guys the car. So here's the car. This is the Dodge Magnum. This is my Magnum with the Hemi in it. I'm gonna come back. I'm gonna show y'all. Hold on, here you go. So this is my Dodge Magnum. All black, just like my other one. This is a 2007 Dodge Magnum with a Hemi in it. As you can see, this can be fixed. I'm not worried about this. Wanna know why? Because I've been watching the YouTuber called Chris Fix, and he shows you how to do that. So shouts out to Chris Fix. So I'm gonna do that. That's gonna be a project for me. You know what I'm saying? Other than that, the car starts up. Everything starts. Only thing that I have to change out that the mechanics told me to change out is the goddamn radiator, bro. And do you know that is a $300 fix? So far, I have put in, I'm gonna put like $700 in this car, and the car runs. It's just that I don't wanna start it because the radiator is shot. You know what I'm saying? So, starts right up and everything. Like, I got a video I'll show you guys that it starts up. Cause I started when I was at the dealership. But like I said, man, door's locked. I didn't think to bring the key. But I can tell you right now, the car needs to be detailed, and I'm gonna get it detailed. It's a whole ass transmission in the back because he replaced the transmission. So it's a brand new, I won't say brand new. It's a new transmission in the car because he thought it was a transmission issue. And everything, and it's an all-wheel drive as well. But I'm gonna try not to drive this car in the winter. I don't wanna put any type of, you know, even though it's all-wheel drive, I don't wanna put a lot on these cars. This car has 178,000 miles on it, and it's so quiet that it's not even funny. So like I said, the only thing that I gotta replace on this car is literally the radiator, and then that engine, that skirt under there. That's like a $60 fix. I just bought a part. And then my boy gonna detail it. And then after that, I'm out here riding again in the Batmobile, baby. So this is my new pickup. This is why I've been, you know, I've been slacking on posting videos, because like I got me another car. I had to you know what I'm saying, buckle down, because, you know, it's always good to have your own shit, baby, you know what I'm saying. So with that said, this is my new pickup. I'm probably gonna start showing you videos on like what I do to this car, and I got some plans of what I want to do to it, but I know plans gonna cost money. So whatever I do to this car, I'm gonna do my best to try to record it, okay? So with that said, man, thanks for watching, and I will talk to you guys later. And y'all stay up and stay safe. Have a good day. Peace.